Hey guys, in the last video, I showed you strange holes drilled into many of the stone blocks of this 1,000-year-old temple known as Preah Vihear in Cambodia. There are many different sizes of holes cut into the rocks, and the purpose of these holes has been a mystery until now. To decode this, we need to look at these ancient floor tiles. Each tile is a square slab of sandstone, but in the center, there is a circular hole. Surprisingly, these holes are not present in one or two slabs or even some tiles. This is what we see in this entire area. Each square tile is of the same size as every other tile, and there's one hole drilled in the center of every tile. Where ancient builders mass manufacturing tiles, just like what we do today. How else can we explain this kind of replication? Here, you can see that the entire area covered with tiles has the exact same feature. If you walk on them looking at these tiles, it is like walking through a mass manufacturing setup. But why was the hole in the center necessary? Archaeologists give a very simple explanation. Stone blocks are not easily movable, because we cannot get a grip on them. So when ancient builders quarried stone blocks from mountains, they made holes so that builders could insert a stick and move them easily. In fact, there are documentaries which explain how multiple holes were drilled into rectangular blocks so they could be moved by men easily. This seems like a convincing explanation, but do all stone blocks have these holes? Let's go to another area in the same temple complex and look at the floor tiling. Look at these stone blocks on the ground. No holes on them at all. But look what they have done to the surface. Here, you can see this work. This is to make sure that you don't fall. Here, and look all the way. This is all grip. This entire place is made of these rocks where the surface was deliberately made rough. They either used sandpaper, acid treatment, or something strange to make it rough. This is incredible. Yes, today we have rugs. Even archaeology department uses rugs or carpets so people don't fall. But this rug is 1,000-year-old, guys, and it will last for eternity, unlike the modern rugs which will disintegrate after 10 years. This is why we love ancient builders, right? They built things that even time can't destroy. But if ancient builders had to put holes in the floor tiles in that area, why do these blocks don't have holes? How were these blocks moved without the holes? I'm not satisfied with the theory of mainstream archaeologists. The holes must have a different purpose. When I examine the walls, the holes are very, very strange and go against these standard explanations. In documentaries, we are told that the holes are drilled through the blocks and wooden sticks are driven through them, and two people would push or pull on both sides. However, none of these holes go through the entire depth or thickness of the stone block. They're very shallow, and I doubt if they're deep enough even to put a stick on them and make them move. To facilitate movement, holes must be drilled symmetrically, that is, either on the ends or at the very center. But the holes in these blocks are weird. There are a bunch of holes in one corner, while the other corner has no holes at all. Some blocks have a lot of holes, and other similar sized blocks have very little number of holes or even no holes at all. And one more thing, these multiple holes defeat the purpose. The temple walls are supposed to be ornate and are supposed to look good. The holes actually make them look bad. So the holes definitely served some other important purpose, but we don't know what it is. But the mystery gets deeper as I explore another temple in the complex. There are some very, very strange and unexplainable features. Look, these are not small little holes. They are huge, gigantic holes, not just one or two, but a series of them, and they're drilled on the floor. These holes are too large for driving any stick and moving them. These holes had a very different purpose. And why so many holes? Remember, I showed you similar holes on the bedrock of Ellora Caves in India. Ellora Caves also has these weird holes on the ground. Those holes were deliberately made for ventilation purposes, for the secret underground city which lies underneath. Even Derinkuyu, an ancient underground city in Turkey, has these ventilation shafts. I have already shown you that this entire temple complex, the Preah Vihear complex, is an artificial pyramid made out of stone blocks. Perhaps there is something inside the pyramid, and maybe some of the holes go all the way underground to the empty chambers situated inside the pyramid. I search eagerly to see if I can find any holes which go deep underground. But as far as I can see, none of these holes are that deep. Today, there are modern wooden stairs put on top of the ancient stairs. And if we peep through the wooden steps, there are many holes. But I'm not able to come to a conclusion. Are these really ventilation shafts? What else could be the purpose of these mysterious holes? The holes actually defeat the purpose of the walkway, because walkways are built for helping people to walk, but the holes make it difficult for the visitors to walk. But there must have been an important reason. Otherwise, these holes would not have been made. Look at the holes, they're quite large, but they're also very well made, as though drilled using a huge boring machine. In Hinduism, there are mentions of advanced tools and devices. For example, there are deities like Bhairavas who are shown with specific devices for digging precious metals like gold. In Cambodia and other Southeast Asian countries, there are ancient devices called kila or katavanga. The popular imagery of deities drilling into the ground is present even as far as South America, in countries like Colombia. Were these holes drilled with tools mentioned in ancient texts? I climb up to the next level because I want to find out if there are more holes on the top. But even on the steps, I can see two huge holes drilled. This is a safety issue because someone might trip and fall because of these holes. A fall from this height can be deadly. When I reach the top, I see more holes drilled on that level as well. There are so many holes everywhere, making it difficult for us to walk around. On one hand, an entire walkway has been made deliberately rough so people will not slip and fall. This shows safety precautions were definitely implemented by ancient builders. On the other hand, it has been deliberately made risky by drilling massive holes on the walkway and even on stairs. What is going on here? We are confused simply because we do not understand the reason for these gigantic holes on the ground. One thing is clear, the traditional theory that these holes were made for inserting sticks and moving them is not true. There are deeper meanings. And in other temples of Cambodia, there is clear evidence to prove this. Here you can see the holes are made after the carving, right on their bodies or faces of the carving, completely defeating the purpose of the carving itself. If archaeologists are right, the holes would have been made when the huge stone blocks were quarried from a mountain, and the sculptors would have made sure these holes do not interfere with the carving. But here, without a doubt, these holes were made after the carving was complete. This is very intriguing and mind-boggling. Now, what is the real reason for these holes? Surprisingly, a local Cambodian takes me inside a chamber and shows me a completely different purpose as to how the Preah Vihear temple was used in ancient times. Inside the chamber, he stands at a specific spot. He thumps his chest and a strange resonance is produced. There is a weird vibration.
You stand in the wall and you chant, you can try.
Chant?
You can't hear what it.
He tells me that this is how this temple was used 1,000 years ago by ancient Hindus. Is it possible that there is a connection between sounds and these holes? Look carefully. The inner walls of the chamber have a lot of holes drilled on the stone blocks. Why? Why do they have to alter a smooth surface and make it uneven by drilling so many holes? Believe it or not, today we use the same technology. Today we patch our rooms and studios with uneven material. And depending on the degree of smoothness or unevenness of the surface, sound becomes suppressed or amplified. This is so obvious when we soundproof a room. It is not just the material that's important. We also make sure we design the surface accordingly. The shape of the surface determines suppression, resonance, echo, or even amplification of the sound. In many, many ancient Hindu sites, chambers are designed to create resonance and echo. I've shown you this in some caves of India as well. When you chant a mantra, sound changes according to the surface of the walls. Were the holes specifically drilled inside so the sound can resonate or reverberate? Is this why there are so many holes and rectangular slots carved here? Are these unexplainable holes on the ground somehow related to sound technology? What else could be their purpose? Why else did ancient builders drill holes on beautifully finished statues and carvings? Were they trying to make the walls create a certain resonant vibration? But was this just for spiritual purposes, or was the sound used for a scientific reason? Perhaps a statue in this chamber might give us a clue. Who is he? He's known as Kala. Kala means time in Sanskrit. This deity is the personification of time.
Crazy vibration. There's crazy vibration here. But I don't know what's on the other side. What is on the other side? What is the meaning of all this? Is this somehow related to time travel? I don't know. Why are people doing all this?
In many ancient sites, there are references to time travel and astral travel. Did ancient people somehow use sound technology for time travel or out-of-body experiences? What is the connection between this statue of time and this resonance? Why are local Cambodians still chanting and praying to this tiny statue of time, while ignoring the hundreds of other statues in this temple complex? Something pulls me behind this statue. It looks like a solid wall, although there's some strange energy on the other side. Let's go outside and see what's on the other side of the wall. When I reach the other side, I'm amazed because there is a huge door. It still has bright paint on it, while most of the temple complex has no trace of paint. What does it mean? It means people have been afraid of touching this door for 1,000 years. This is why the paint is still there. It's made of multiple polygonal stone blocks. On top, again, we can see Kala, time itself, overseeing the door. Is this a mere coincidence, or is this door some kind of a time portal? Why else is time carved on both sides? Here, it is carved on the top of the door, and on the other side is a statue of Kala. Is it possible to open this? I try to open it, but I can't. It has hinges, and it is very ornate like a real door, but it cannot be opened by ordinary means. Perhaps it can be opened with some type of sound. But to fully understand this, I need to understand the frequency of this temple. Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give this video a thumbs up and do share it with your friends. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.